So what is the formula we are getting from this triangle? P is equal to VI cos phi. Okay, VI means total. Okay, VI here means this VI means total apparent power. Okay, so total apparent power. Okay, then product with what? Cos phi. Cos phi means power factor. Cos phi means power factor. Okay, then you will get the power across the resistance. Okay, that is how much. Okay, what is the real power? Okay, how much total power is distributed to the resistor? That is called as a power. Okay, so that is decided by the power factor. More the power factor, more power will be distributed to the resistor. Rest of the power will go to the what? Inductor or capacitor. Okay, now and again, how to calculate the power across this one? Okay, how to calculate this Q? Okay, so for that I can take help of this one. Sin pi is equal to Q divided by S. Okay, then what is Q? Q is equal to S into sin pi. And again, what is S? S means VI sin pi. Okay, so what is Q? Q means power across the element, inductor or capacitor. Okay, so VI sin pi. Okay, that sin pi, simply you use it as a sin pi. Okay, there is no name here. Okay, so and if you take this is like a total power. Okay, total power, total apparent power into sin pi. Once if you observe one thing here, you take some pi, okay, some pi, pi is equal to some degree, say 60 degree. Okay, once if you calculate cos pi, you will get some value. Okay, then if you calculate here, say for example, if you are getting x here, okay, cos 60 degree x, then you will get 1 minus x here. Okay, because here it is sin. Okay, they are just like opposite. Okay, they are just like opposite. Okay, so because you are having some total power, okay, so out of total power, this much power is distributed to P, then the remaining power, the remaining this proportional power will be distributed to Q. Okay, so Q is equal to VI sin pi. Okay, so finally, what is important to calculate the P? We are having so many formulas. Okay, this is also one formula, VI cos pi. VI means supplied voltage and supplied current. Okay, it's like a total voltage and a total current, and again here cos pi. Okay, and one more thing, this, what is this V value? Okay, V and I simply we are using. Okay, whenever AC power is calculated, please remember this, very very important. Okay, so AC power, okay, whenever you calculate the power for AC signal, then you have to take the RMS value only. Okay, you cannot take the peak value, only you have to take the RMS value. Okay, in the next class I'll tell you what is RMS value, but please remember, whenever you calculate the AC power, okay, that means power due to the AC signal, then you have to take the RMS value. So by default, this VI and all, what's RMS? Okay, VI and all RMS, whether they mention or not, that is RMS only. Okay, so I can also write like this: VRMS, IRMS, cos phi, like that I can write. Or otherwise, you can also write, if it is a peak value, if it is VM, IM, peak value divided by 2, then again cos pi will be there. Okay, here also that only. So you can write either VRMS, IRMS, cos pi, sorry, sin pi, RMS, sin pi, or otherwise, if you take the peak value, VM, IM divided by 2, then sin pi. Okay, so that is the idea. Next, I will take the voltage triangle. Okay, I can also take voltage triangle here. Okay, so AC power means you have to take the RMS value. Okay, next I will take the voltage triangle. Okay, voltage triangle, not the voltage triangle, the phasor relationship with respect to current and voltage. Okay, with respect to current and voltage. Okay, we are discussing about series RL circuit. Okay, series RL circuit, RL. Okay, even though RL is there, then again, you know, that will be dominated by L. Okay, because we are including L. Okay, so again, in L, what will happen in case of inductor? Voltage will lead the current. Okay, in inductor, voltage will lead the current. Okay, First, I'll write once. If you see this diagram, okay, the main original diagram. If you see here, okay. So and again, the I is coming here. Okay, as soon as the I comes, and again we are and this I will be in phase. That you have to understand first, okay? Because I is coming here. Again, you know the current and voltage across the resistance. They will be in phase, V and I. But this current and this voltage will be in phase. But if you see, and again the same current is coming here, okay, once if it sees the inductor, again this current and this voltage will be out of phase by 90 degree, okay, because I am comparing the current with only inductor. Okay, the current is coming this way. When it is across the resistance, both current and voltage will be in phase. But once it comes here, this current and this voltage will be exactly 90 degree out of phase, okay. And again, I am not comparing with this one, okay. I am comparing with the current, okay, because current is coming here already, VL is there. Then this voltage and current across the inductor will have 90 degree phase shift, okay. And again, with all this parameter, okay, this will be having some angle, okay. And we have to calculate that angle also, okay, where V bar is residing. Okay, so one by one I will write, okay, because first I will take I as a reference. From that I will proceed. So and again, it's better to draw the diagram once again, okay, because if this is R, this is L, V, this is I bar, this is VR bar, this is VL bar, okay. Now draw the phasor relationship, okay. Listen carefully. First, I will take I as a reference because I is common in the branch. Okay, it's in the loop. Okay, so now I will take I as a reference. Okay, if I is the reference means, say for example, I take I in this manner. Okay, I, and again it is clear this both I and VR will be in same phase. Okay, same direction, but the magnitude could be anything. Okay, I may be greater or VR may be greater. That really depends on R. Okay, that is not a matter. So I can write here, or I can also write here, no problem. Okay, so I'll write here VR. Okay, you can write anywhere because it really depends on the R value. Okay, either it is greater than 1 or less than 1. Okay, once if it is like this, both the voltage, okay, and again I cannot write, I can also write as IR, but that I is the current across the resistance is same as the other resistance. That's why I'm not writing it as IR. Okay, it's simply like a I, but this I and this V are in phase. Okay, now the same current is coming here. Okay, the same current is coming here, but now it is seeing the voltage, inductor voltage VL. You know one thing, whenever inductor is there, the voltage will lead the current by 90 degrees. So already if the current is like this, then the voltage will be like 90 degree. Okay, this is the VL. Okay, now my VL is here, VR is here, then where will be my V bar? Where will be my V bar? Okay, so just you connect this virtually, okay, then your V will be in this direction. Okay, your V will be in this direction. Okay, this is your V finally. Okay, source voltage. Okay, so individually we are drawing V, I, VL, then finally we are including this V bar. Now once if you draw this diagram, you can know the phase difference between the all the component, the current and voltage, like that. Okay, now you can write the phase difference very easily. Okay, so from this also, what is finally important? Finally, what is important? What is the supplied voltage? What is the supplied current? What is the phase difference between them? Okay, that is decided by both L and R. So finally, in this diagram, where is V bar? Where is I bar? This is V bar. This is I bar. The phase difference between them, I will write it as a pi. Okay, I will write it as a pi because this is like a circuit, RL. Okay, for that circuit, what is the phase difference? Okay, for that circuit, when I apply some voltage, okay, what is the current phase? Okay, difference between the phase difference between the voltage and current. Okay, so I have to compare this one. Okay, because when I analyze from this position, okay, now I want to write the relationship for the circuit, entire circuit R and L. Okay, now what is the phase relationship? That is pi. Okay, that pi is actually less than 90 degree and greater than 0 degree. Okay, less than 90 degree, greater. So once if you observe this, okay, if it sometime this V bar may come towards this one, okay, when it will come, if if your inductor value is zero, okay, what will happen? Slowly it will reduce. Okay, if the inductor effect is decreasing, the VL will decrease slowly. Once if we decrease this one, this diagram will come to down. Okay, if L is zero, then really your voltage will be along this axis only, because once if inductor is not there, everything voltage and current, everything is going to be on phase. But what will happen? Suppose if you increase the inductor nature, okay, you are increasing the inductor nature, but decreasing the resistance. Okay, once if you decrease the resistance, say for example, if the resistance goes to zero, what will happen? This VR will go to zero. Once if this VR will go to zero, then what will happen? This diagram will merge here. Yes, that is true only because when the resistance is not there, okay, the voltage and the current, okay, has to be exactly at a 90 degree, but now it is not 90 degree. See, this VL and I may be at 90 degree, but that is not important to us. What it is important, the angle between V bar and I bar is the important to us, because we are analyzing the entire circuit, not about the inductor. We are analyzing the entire circuit. That means you have to compare V bar with the I bar. Okay, so now the phase difference is pi. Okay, from this what you can write, cos pi you can write. Okay, cos pi means so VR, okay, this side, okay, this side divided by this one, VR divided by V, cos pi. Or again you can also write tan pi. What is tan pi here? Okay, tan pi is equal to, sir, what is the tan pi? This side, okay, this side means this one, VL divided by VR. Okay, tan pi is equal to VL divided by VR. Or otherwise you can also write sin pi. Okay, what is sin pi? Sin pi is equal to VL divided by V. Okay, VL divided by V. Then finally, what is V? Okay, I want to calculate this V. Okay, the V value is, again you can modify this diagram virtually like this. Okay, VR you can take right like this. This vector you can put like this, nothing will change, no problem. You can put this line here, then it is like this. Okay, so this is VR, and again this is VL. Okay, this is like VR, this is VL, and then this is V. So from this, V means what, sir? VR square plus VL square, overall square root. So that means what? How this voltage will be distributed, because this voltage, entire voltage will be distributed like this, square root of VR square and VL square. Okay, that is the mod V value. This mod V is equal to square root of VR square and VL square. Okay, so next we'll go to the RC circuit. Yes sir, idhula edha doubt iruka? Series RL circuit la
sir.
Solunga
sir. Ipa Thevenin's Norton solirkeengala sir? Ipa idu vandu voltage source a irukku, idu Norton circuit la parallel la varudhu nachukku sir.
Adellame thaniya irukku sir, parallel combination namma poda dhaan porom.
Anga current vandu applicable aagum
RL ke, namma parallel combination podom sir. Adukapram na kelunga enna doubt nu. RL parallel combination irukku namakitta. Okay sir. Okay. Okay, so next to pathina series RC circuit. Okay, so now we're having some voltage source R is there, and again C. Okay, this is V bar and I bar. So final interest is, what is the phase difference between the V and I due to the combination of R and C? Okay, that is our aim. Okay, this is R, this is C. Okay, this is VR, this is VC, and I, one, the same I is coming here, the same I will come here also for the capacitor. And again, the I and VC will have 90 degree phase shift, I and VC, but this I and this V not necessary. Okay, it may be at any other phase. Okay, not necessarily to be 90 degree, because this nature is not purely capacitor. But once if this current comes here only, if you see, the nature is purely capacitor. That's why that this current and this voltage will have 90 degree phase shift, but this voltage and this current may have any phase shift, okay, other than 90 degree. That will be decided by this circuit parameters R and C. Okay, once if you apply the KVL, minus V bar plus VR bar plus VC bar is equal to zero, V is equal to VR bar plus VC bar, and again V bar is equal to VR means IR, VC means, okay, this impedance, that is minus J into XC into I, okay, then you can take I outside, V bar is equal to I bar R minus J XC, okay, that V bar means I bar, it's like a Z, okay, now in this case, the Z is R minus J XC or otherwise R minus J 1 divided by omega C, 1 divided by omega C. And again, okay, so now Z nature is R minus J XC. Z is equal to R minus, previously we got R plus J XC, now we are getting R minus J XC. So now if I take R as a reference, okay, this is the reference R, then minus J means, okay, it is lagging, okay, so I will write in the opposite manner, okay, previously I was putting the line upward, now I will put the line downward, okay, it is something similar to this one, okay, if R is going like this, then this will be minus 90 degree phase shift, okay, so this is same thing only, so I will put my XC here, okay, my XC here, then this is R and this is XC, then I can connect this, okay, that will give Z, okay, this is my pi now, okay, now from this and again virtually you can imagine this circuit as like this, okay, so some voltage source is there, some impedance is connected, okay, now I am providing V, some I is going, now Z is R minus, okay, JXC, okay, because of this impedance, okay, this will have some phase shift, okay, total. And again, finally, there will be phase difference between the voltage and the current. That only I'm going to find from here. Okay, now what is that phase difference that is given as pi or theta? Okay, pi here. Okay, now how can I calculate the pi? And again, before calculating the pi, what is the value of Z? Z means R square plus XC square. Okay, square root of R square plus XC square. Then what is pi? Okay, first you write cos pi. Cos pi means what? Cos pi means R divided by mod Z. Okay, then what is the sin pi? Sin pi is equal to XC divided by mod Z. Then what is tan pi? Okay, tan pi is equal to XC divided by R. Okay, so I can find in any way I want. So based on the parameter that they are giving, we have to use the corresponding formula. So finally, what is important? You should know this triangle, okay, properly. Okay. From this, again, we can write the power equation. Okay, once if you proceed from this, we can write the power equation. Okay, I will multiply with the I square on both sides. Okay, Z minus R minus JXC. Once if you multiply both sides, I square Z, I square R minus J, I square XC. This I means I into V, I square R minus J, I square XC. Okay, so this is like S, this is like P, this is like J, this is QC, okay, Q due to the capacitor. Okay, now again, we can mention this as a triangle. This S is equal to P minus JQ. I can mention as a triangle. If this is P, okay, this is Q because this is minus JQ. That's why I'm putting down. This is Q and again, this is S, this is pi. Okay, so and again, from this triangle, what is cos pi? Cos pi is equal to P divided by S, okay, then that means P is equal to S into cos pi. S means what? VI cos pi. Okay, what is the unit of this one? Watt. Okay, similarly, I can find QC also. Okay, once if you take sine pi for the triangle, then that will become Q divided by S, then Q is equal to S into sine pi. S means VI sine pi, but what is the unit here? Volt ampere reactive. Volt ampere reactive. So, and then finally, I'll write the phase difference between the voltage and current. For that, I will take this reference diagram, same diagram, I'll draw here. Okay, now R is there, C is there. This is the applied voltage V, RC, this is VR, this is VC, this is V bar, this is I bar. Okay, now I'll take again in the circuit what is common, current is common. So I'll take I as a reference. Okay, I'll draw I like this. Okay, now the current is coming and again this current and this voltage, okay, voltage across the resistance, they will be in parallel. Sorry, they will be in phase. Okay, they will be in phase That's why I is riding here, VR I am riding here in the same line. And the same current is coming here, okay? But you know, across the capacitor, the current and the voltage across the capacitor will have 90 degree phase shift, but that too, the current will lead by the voltage. That's why I'll put my capacitor voltage VC here, because between the current and capacitor voltage, that should be the 90 degree phase shift. Now my current is same as the capacitor current, because the same current is flowing into the capacitor. Okay, so I can write it as I, or no problem, I can also write it as IC. Okay, so now the capacitor current and capacitor voltage always will have 90 degree phase shift, but the voltage will lag. That's why I'm putting 90 degree like this, okay, downwards. Okay, then what will be the V? The V will be anywhere in between this one. Okay, the V will be somewhere like this. Okay, once if we connect this one, then that will give you the V, direction of V. Okay, from this diagram, you can write V is equal to VR square, VC square, overall square root. Okay, overall square root. And clearly, okay, see, already somehow we have found out what is the relationship between the current and voltage. That means this V and this I. Okay, so what is happening? Definitely I is leading the voltage, but not by 90 degree, with some other angle. Okay, whenever if you have really capacitor, that is 90 degree, but if it is capacitor along with the resistance, you will not get a 90 degree phase shift, you will get phase shift other than 90 degree, but that still it will be showing the properties of the capacitor. Properties of the capacitor means what? Here what is happening? I leads V by what degree? By pi degree. Okay, so because if you measure the angle between this I and this V, this angle is called as pi. Okay, the angle between this I and this V is a pi. Okay, so I can write the rest of the parameter. Okay, cos pi is equal to VR divided by V. Okay, then tan pi is equal to VC, okay, voltage across the capacitor divided by VR. Okay, so this is the idea for RC circuit, okay, series RC circuit. Okay, let's wait a bit.